Hello and welcome to my channel. So, as you may know, veganism has become a really big thing in the US and around the world. So, to explore why this is happening, we're going to do a 4-week exploration into veganism. And we'll begin with week one with an introduction into veganism and why so many people have decided to adapt this diet. So to begin with, we'll discuss the history of veganism. So veganism started with Donald Watson in 1944 when he co-founded the Vegan Society in England. And the term first referred to a non-dairy vegetarian. But a few years later, in 1951, the term redefined to mean the doctrine that man should live without exploiting animals. And this interest for veganism really started happening in the 2010s. Moving on, what really is veganism, and what does a vegan diet mean? So veganism is the practice from abstaining from all animal products, and the followers are called vegans. Well-planned vegan diets can reduce the risk of some types of chronic illnesses and diseases such as heart disease. So there are different types of vegans, a lot of different types of vegans, but generally there are, I would say, three. There are dietary vegans, ethical vegans, as well as environmental veganism. So ethical vegans are strict vegetarians that refrain from consuming animal products. For dietary purposes, for your diet health-wise, there are also ethical vegans, and they follow a vegan diet but extend this philosophy into other aspects of their life and oppose the use of animals for any purpose. So these people really do it for the ethical reasons, including the animals and such. And the third main type are environmental veganism. So this is the avoidance of animal products on the premise that the harvesting of industrial farming of animals is environmentally damaging and unsustainable. So on the vegan diet, there are some obvious foods to avoid, like butter and cream, eggs, cheese from cows or goats, as well as milk from cows or goats, meat, poultry, lamb, beef, as well as like seafood such as fish, shellfish, shrimp, and lobster, as well as gelatin and honey. There are some other foods that are not really as obvious as having animal products, and this includes bagels, bread products, beer and wine, candy, Jello, marshmallows, non-dairy creamer, potato chips, peanuts, and refined sugar. So these would also be restricted and not allowed on the vegan diet. So this brings the question, what can you eat then? And there's still lots of options. Some include fruits and vegetables, herbs and spices, beans, soy-based proteins such as tofu, grains and pasta that's not made from eggs. So with this in mind, why go vegan? So we'll discuss that. So there are a lot of benefits as well as drawbacks. One benefits includes that it does promote weight loss, although excessive weight loss can become weight gain. And vegans are at reduced risk of serious illness, which is a huge, huge benefit. However, vegans do lack some vital nutrients, such as B12 and calcium. However, the rebuttal to this is that there are alternative sources of B12 and of these vitamins. However, it could be difficult in the outside environment, in restaurants or in family gatherings, although there is a big shift to more vegan products and foods in restaurants, at least. So it is becoming easier to buy plant-based proteins and foods, which is helpful and a pro. However, the vegan diet is majority, a small percentage of Americans define themselves as vegans, and so may not be welcoming in society or perhaps in a family dynamic. However, it is extremely more environmentally sustainable, which is very, very important, and it helps lower cholesterol and blood pressure. However, it does take effort to buy and make these vegan foods and to find out where you can buy these vegan foods, and a consciousness to check the labels and check the ingredients and make sure that it is on the right diet that you want to follow. So, as I mentioned, there are not a lot of vegans. Most people do associate themselves as meat eaters, but there are some pretty famous vegans. This includes Beyonce, Jay-Z, Miley Cyrus, Liam Hemsworth, Ariana Grande, Ellen DeGeneres and her wife, as well as Jessica Simpson, and these are all great people to look up to. If all these people are doing it, just be some kind of reason to it. To further this exploration, there are many vegan alternatives which are helpful when transitioning and just when maintaining your diet. To substitute milk, there's soy milk, almond milk, hemp milk. For cheese, the alternative would be a vegan cheese. One brand is called Dia. Eggs, for scrambled eggs, there is a tofu scramble. For beef and chicken stock, the alternative would be a vegetable stock, a very simple, alternative, nothing life-changing. For butter, there's a vegan butter. These tend to be harder to find a good tasting one, but Earth Balance has one available. For honey, maple syrup is a great alternative. For chocolate, there are alternatives. There are non-dairy vegan chocolate. And for meat, there are meat alternatives. There's chickpea patties, black bean burgers, chicken substitutes. There are ways to get creative and still have enough protein and have a good diet if you're willing to try and willing to test and willing to explore. So with this in mind, there are some vegan recipes or just some things to think about, I guess. So if we start in the morning with breakfast, there are vegan pancakes, and I said earlier, tofu, scramble, simple things like that. Breakfast is a really good way of getting in your protein for the day, or you know, a good chunk of it at least. There are vegan milk, almond milk, and things like that that are high in protein. For lunch, there are different types of soup, like a lentil soup with just a vegetable stock and many vegetables and bean or lentil that will give you that protein. And then for dinner, it can be followed up with a black bean burger or a chickpea burger that have that protein. Of course, you cannot forget dessert. And there are plenty of vegan desserts that I'm sure people make that are meat eaters. Dessert. It's a little simpler. There are vegan chocolate chip cookies and lots of great recipes that use